not her.
This place seems strange. Wish there were more humans around.
Greetings,
Commander Shepard. I am Nasana Dantius. I see you got my message.
What do you want?
You said you had a job offer.
I do. My sister Dahlia is a crewman on the cargo vessel operating out beyond the fringes of the Traverse. Her ship was attacked by privateers. There were no reported survivors.
Now you want revenge.
You want me to hunt down the people who killed her?
This is where it gets complicated. Last week, I received a message with her voice on it. Dahlia is alive.
Hmm.
The rest of the crew was killed, but she was taken prisoner. The slavers demanded a huge ransom from me in exchange for returning her unharmed.
Why do you think your sister was spared?
Why didn't the raiders kill Dahlia along with everyone else?
My sister probably told them who she was. My family's very wealthy, Shepard. They must have realized she was worth more to them alive.
What's my part?
Do you want me to deliver the ransom?
I've already transferred the funds to the account they specified. Only they never released her. They haven't contacted me since. I've made a terrible mistake, Shepard. I'm a diplomatic emissary. By law, I'm required to report any attempted extortion to CSEC immediately. I was afraid for Dahlia, so I just paid the ransom. Now she's still missing, and if anyone finds out what I did, I could end up in jail.
So you came to me.
You want me to find her and bring her back?
You only need to bring her back. I've already found her for you. I tracked the ransom payment through several accounts. Eventually, it led to a small mercenary band operating out of the Artemis Tau cluster. I need you to go to the Merc base, take them out, and bring my sister back. You shall be well rewarded.
What do you know about these kidnappers?
Anything you can tell me about the Mercs who have your sister?
Pretty much what you'd expect. Rough, dangerous, and well armed. Nothing a Spectre cannot handle, though.
Why me, specifically?
Can't you hire someone else to do this?
I do not want to take chances with my sister's life. I need a Spectre. Besides, you operate outside official channels. My superiors cannot find out I never reported the ransom in the first place.
Tracking the ransom.
How'd you find out who was behind the ransom?
I have resources. Contacts and credits can go a long way. Especially if you're willing to bend the rules. I already broke the law when I paid the ransom. This couldn't make things any worse.
I'll do it.
Don't worry. I'll bring your sister back.
Thank you, Shepard. I knew you were the right woman for the job. Come back and see me when the job is done.
Oh, it was under... Okay. Go to the Mastodon system in the Artemis Tau cluster and infiltrate the mercenary base. I'm not completely sure if I'm going to be doing that right away. It is so funny, I thought those shadows were dirt smudges or blood or something. Was this? Is this where he came out of? Yeah.
So tell me. Who'd win in a fight between you and Shepard?
Oh!
Do Krogan size up everyone for a fight? Even friends and allies?
Yes.
Simple answer. I admit I'm a little biased, but I think I would win. So many elevators.
In entertainment news, Francis Kitt has announced plans to direct Hamlet with Elcor cast members. The production will open dramatic theater to the Elcor with a Hamlet who uses Elcor body language and pheromones. Kitt claims that he's also excited by giving a human audience the chance to judge Hamlet by his deeds and not his emotions.
That's pretty outrageous. I'd actually really like to see that. Don't think we would, though. It was kind of silly just to arbitrarily stop by here because one person radios us, but eh.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress. Logged. The commanding officer is aboard. Exo Presley stands relieved.
I wonder if Joker would have anything to say about this inspection.
Commander, something you need?
How's the Normandy performing? Is she everything they
said? She's the best ship in the fleet. Yeah. Balance isn't what you'd expect. The Normandy's probably too much ship for your average Alliance pilot.
I have to go.
All right, see you.
He loves when we cut him off like that, I'm sure. No one has anything to say about this inspection?
Yes, Commander.
Carry on, Presley.
Yes, ma'am.
I guess not. I don't want to wander about the whole ship. It doesn't appear like they have anything to say. I mean, maybe the guy, whoever that is with the in engineering, but I'm not sure.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
Another message?
Commander, Ms. Algelani's story on you just aired.
Huh?
She shouldn't have ambushed you like that. But you handled it pretty well.
Is that a... was that a former commander of the ship? I did the best I could.
We had differences of opinion, sir. I hope she at least believed my sincerity.
You handled yourself pretty well, Commander. She came across like a raving idiot. Just wanted to let you know what the response was back home. I won't keep you any longer. Fifth Fleet out.
So we get these messages when we go to, the map. Widow Cluster. Did I check out? I don't even remember. Did I check out the Exodus cluster? I'm thinking Exodus cluster, then Hades Gamma, and then the Liara's dig site. Utopia, okay. So we've been there. Had a feeling. Hades Gamma. I think we have something to do there. Antaeus is the only one. We got Antaeus and Farinata is the one. Sounds familiar. Something going on there, right?
Commander, urgent message from Alliance Command coming in. I'll patch it through.
All these messages.
Shepard, this is Admiral Hackett from Alliance Command.
Admiral Hackett.
We've got a situation here, and you're the only one that can handle it.
How can I help?
What do you need, Admiral?
There's an Alliance training ground where we test weapons and technology in live fire simulations. One of the VIs we use to simulate enemy tactics in the drills is no longer responding to our override commands. It's gone rogue.
It's gone rogue?
Are you telling me this computer is thinking on its own?
We're not stupid, Shepard. This is a virtual intelligence, not a true AI. It's not self-aware, and it can't access any external systems. We didn't do anything illegal here. Virtual intelligence support is critical to our military success. VIs process thousands of status reports and react in nanoseconds. No human can do that. We need you to fight your way through the training ground of the VI Corps and manually disable it.
Huh. Is that the only option?
Can't you disable it remotely?
Our fail-safes aren't responding. The VI operates on a closed network. It can't affect any external systems, but we don't have any direct access to its processes. We could bomb it from orbit, but the damage to the facility would be catastrophic. We'd prefer to have someone shut down the core. Someone like you. I know Spectre's answered the Council, but you're still human. You're still part of the Alliance military, and right now we need you. The VI controls all the facility's weapons, drones, and automated defenses. You're the only one that can pull this off, Shepard. Good luck.
Yeah, as far as I'm aware, we are still human. MSV Ontario. I wish I could access my journal without coming back out. Let's look at these planets first, and then we'll check this out. Tunshagon. Tunshagon is a hydrogen-helium gas giant with traces of chlorine and nitrogen in its atmosphere. It has an unusually small number of moons for a gas giant, a mere 7. This is no doubt due to the star Farinata capturing the majority of the mass during the nebular collapse that created the system. Unknown. Ooh, check that out after. Second planet is this one. Gentama. By the way, guys, I know I'm throwing this out in the middle of all this, but there's a game coming out in June that I'm pretty excited about. I normally don't pre-order stuff, but I pre-ordered it just so that, you know, who knows if I have money in June. I mean, so I did it just so I'd be able to get to this game when it comes out. It's called No Man's Sky. And if you don't know about it, go check it out. Go look it up on Steam or GOG offices as well. There's a Wikipedia entry. Of course, there's a website to, you know, for the game. And yeah, it's all about, you're basically thrown in with a bunch of other people. And, you know, whoever's on, you're basically online with them, but you're light years away from them, and it's interesting. It's like an experimental type game, I think. It's, you might not encounter anyone until you head to the center of the universe, I think, or a galaxy, I'm not sure. And, yeah, then you might run across people, because that's your eventual destination. There's something there that needs to be checked out, but you can survey planets like we're doing here. You could land on planets, run around and catalog life forms. There are beacons on these planets from, like, similar to the Prothean civilizations have left stuff behind that that we can utilize. So yeah, it's pretty interesting. So you can log your planets, name the planets, and you know, be the first one to, you know, have basically log this planet, name it whatever you want, all the species you can track. Some of them are dangerous to you, some are not, of course, and you can get in galactic battles as well with raiders, privateers. You can be a privateer and attack other ships for their resources, which would most likely be, you know, they'll be AI-controlled ships because you're not going to run into anybody, at least for a long time. And your chances of doing so, I mean, you're basically placed so far apart. And the whole thing is procedurally generated. You could also set up trade routes and stuff and, you know, just make money, trade stuff back and forth. It's pretty freaking interesting. So I'll be playing that at least, you know, I don't know if I'm going to be recording the whole thing, but definitely highlights of it. So I'm gonna have that going on probably, well, definitely we're still gonna be in the middle of Mass Effect 1 or 2, and I'll have my other, my B-roll going on, which would be shorter games, and every once in a while, yeah, I'll be throwing in an EverQuest and throwing in a No Man's Sky. If you're watching this years later, go check out my playthrough, and hopefully it's up. I mean, if it isn't, then for some reason I'm unable to record it, and who knows. Anyway, yeah, looking forward to that. And that's just reminded me, doing surveys of these planets reminded me of that. Of course, it's not going to be advanced, anywhere near advanced as Mass Effect games, but it really looks good. It really has a clean interface, and it's pretty interesting. And actually promoted by Sony, believe it or not. It's going to be coming out on PlayStation 4 and PC so far. For Windows, anyway. So, yeah. Juntama. Juntama is a small, broiling terrestrial world. Its thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide and ethane is being steadily blown off by the powerful solar wind from the star Farinata. The surface is scorching hot and mainly composed of sulfur with deposits of copper. Its density is low enough to leave the world tidally locked to Farinata. The Alliance Defense Data Network notes that several ships have been spotted cruising near Juntama with transponders turned off. Really? While an Alliance patrol attempted pursuit of one, the unidentified vessel rabbited to faster than light. Its trail was lost when it obscured its light trace in the confusion of signals along the Anansi Ishtar shipping lane. Alright, let's survey this planet. Prothean data disk recovered. Scans of Juntama revealed a derelict freighter in mid-stage orbital decay. Your salvage team boarded the vessel and determined it had been attacked by raiders. There was little of value still on board, but the team did find a Prothean data disk. You know, I read this stuff and I actually, you know, want to do it, not read about it. But I'm sure we're going to be doing plenty of stuff like this, boarding salvage freighters and stuff like that at some point. So that's Juntama. So there's only three planets in this system. Got a white star here. Tunshagan. Oh wait, I already looked at this. Okay, I'm working my way outward, not inward. Forgot. Nepnu? Almost looks like nephew. You could survey this one too. With a rare combination of features, Nepnu is of particular interest to the scientific community. Nepnu is a small terrestrial planet with a funny name, with a thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide and krypton. As with all the worlds of Farinata, its surface is scorching hot. The crust mainly consists of silicates laced with iron. Rare elements surveyed. While scanning this planet, you detected a large deposit of thorium on a nearby moon. Cool. Alright, what else? We've got the MSV Ontario. Is that a ship? And then we've got this unknown sector here, which I kind of found by mistake. Oh, it's winking like that. Sending out a distress signal? Let me just see what this is. The Ontario is a Kowloon-class modular conveyor of human design, configured for mixed freight and passenger hauling. It is making a hard burn for the cover of an asteroid cluster. Registry Private Owner Citadel Station. Okay, so we are boarding a supposedly derelict freighter. My wish has been granted. Huh. Rex Tally. Oh no, I'm kind of I like this crew. I like the brute strength of Rex. And he has a great personality. And Tally. I tend to find the humans boring, and Garrus would be my choice if not for one of these two. Now the only problem is, I'm not sure, because we're leveling these guys up. If I stay with them too long, will I be stuck with them? Or if I choose Garrus at some point, will he level up to, you know, match us? Do not know. I'm sure you guys can confirm or deny that. So has this been commandeered by... Let me check my... The Sol system. Farinata system. Find the freighter and make your way to the biotics on board. Okay. Tornado 4 and Katana 4. Both shotguns. Alright, so... Nice. Katana 4 is pretty sweet. It's, wow, 213. This stuff's all better than what he has. Scimitar 3. 213. Let's get rid of Scimitar 3. Now we can use shotguns at this point. We already have Katana 4. Okie doke. Nothing around here. Okay. What do you guys have to say about this? This stuff. Nothing? No comment. Oh, okay. All of a sudden, cat's got your tongue. Stuff goes nowhere. These aren't doors. They look like they could be doors. Man, this place is spooky. Huge open area. Chairman Burns is over here. I guess we did a life form scan.
Intruders!
Oh.
Kill the hostage!
Damn, oh! Let's move.
You man!
I will destroy you!
Holy crap! Oh, I'm down! There's too many. Oh, we got him. Okay. Okay, we need to haul ass. What do we need to... Do we need to get to him by that time, or what? I'm not even sure. Oh, I hit the wrong thing. Really? I think I told him to stay there by mistake. This music reminds me of, Day of the Dead. Time stopped, right? So we can do this? Crap. Damn it. Alright. Ooh, Terminators. Assault rifles. .180. Terminator 4. We've got a couple of them. Banshee and Lancer. Yeah, this is part in Day of the Dead, the movie from the 80s, where she's hanging out with the Jamaican helicopter pilot and the German guy who she ends up having to chop his arm off, or they chop his arm off, and yeah, basically that din din din, that it's basically, I don't know how to describe it, a lonely kind of spooky, yet it's got a class to it. The theme that was playing at that point. Hell yeah. Well, she can't use a shotgun anyway. Alright. See, there it goes. That's what it reminds me of. Where are we? Alright, we took a wrong turn here. Need to go this way. Give me the control.
See how it is? You write letters and everyone ignores you. Force is the only thing people appreciate. So how about if I kill Chairman Burns and finish the charade?
Please! I was trying to help you people!
Calm down.
Let's not do anything we're all gonna regret.
Why not? What have we got to lose?
Your life.
Since the chairman here decided that we didn't get reparations, we've got nothing left to live for.
But I've changed my mind. Seeing you all, it's clear that you all deserve...
You had your chance. Some L2s are nearly crippled from side effects of the implants, but you voted against reparations.
Don't be stupid.
If you die fighting, you'll get a lot of biotics killed as well.
What do you mean?
You're hurting your cause.
If people think that all L2 biotics are violent extremists, what is that going to accomplish?
But people need to hear about what the government has done and what it has failed to do.
People have already heard. You don't have to kill me to make your point.
You're right.
Smart move.
I don't want to die. Maybe something will happen this time. We surrender.
Yay.
Thank you, Commander. I thought I was dead when they took me. I'll see to it that the reparations discussion is reopened.
Huh.
I didn't know they were so desperate.
It's a very weird-looking face. I was just doing my job.
A 5th Fleet cruiser will be by shortly to pick you and the prisoners up.